Mez has Icebound Fortitude, but Trill has no touch of Karma. Portals for the heal.
The cops won't have that trinket available for the full blind later on from Nick, and they still have that smoke bomb to fall back on, so they have a lot of options here in terms of who they are going to go after. And Cubs is going to need to do a good job here with keeping his Earth Shield swapped now to himself, and he does have it on Chun-Li for now as that full blind comes out. And it looks like Neat are trying to go after Chanimal here, but Chanimal does a great job kiting, fearing up Nick, and also shutting down that sap. So one of those big win conditions for Neat has gone out of the window.
Go after Chanimal. Go after who? He may as well be a ghost. He's just untouchable in most of these matches on that Affliction Warlock, dragging these games on for quite some time with his great kiting. And I think they're going to ultimately have to go after Chun-Li or Cubsy in the end of this. We see Incarnation pop. They're trying to put Chanimal down. Pops the unending resolve to reverse the pressure. Tiber immediately retreats back behind the pillar. But it's a ton of damage out of nowhere from Chun-Li. Massive touch of
these
death.
Preemptive defensive cooldown moves, or else he's going to get stun locked and destroyed.
This crowd control chain on Cubsy has been quite long. And now, because they've sustained it, Chanimal is forced to use unending resolve. It's still endless right now, it seems. Tiber, though, getting counter pressured, caught into a Blood Elf Silence. Korlek using Trinket and Divine Shield. Maybe a bit of a mistake there. He's not even going to have to use the Sacrifice. That's actually going to put Korlek incredibly far behind. And this is where I would critique Neat, is that their setups are good, but when they go in aggressively, they either overuse or they don't push in at all. They need to time these defensives better when they're pushing in to be able to find a kill, because now they're incredibly far behind.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the problem here. You can't really push in like that and just use all of your defensives offensively like that unless you're sure you're going to land a kill. But now we do see a full seduce onto Korlek. No way out of that one. Do they have follow-up CC? Do they have incap? You see Nick dropping very low. You see Tiber dropping very low. And they're going to take him down just based off of that trinket bubble overlap from Korlek. And Cubs' trinket, and he manages to hold on to it. However, a 3-minute cooldown for a 2-minute cooldown, which is the blind, is not a too bad trade for Neat, but they're going to have to rinse and repeat this a couple of times. They're going to have to get a big CC chain onto Cubsy. There it is. Brute Solar Beam. Chanimal's taking a lot of damage. They need to get Cubsy's trinket on this CC chain here. But again, Chun-Li with the incapacitate, with the double fist of fury, and Chanimal's is going to get away with that fear spam as well. Doing a great job here, kiting. But right now, Korlek is doing fine on mana. We can see Tiber has his Bark Skin active. He's going to be fine. Nick has his Cloak of Shadows. So the game is kind of reset at this point, and they could potentially get Cubsy's trinket on that next blind, and that could really open up Chanimal's for dying in a smoke bomb later.
Oh, the smoke bomb right here and now. No defenses from Chun-Li, but Cubsy sneaks in for a Spearling Totem. Cubsy actually getting sapped as he moves in. Spearling not breaking that. Now Nick, though, falling behind and ultimately KO'd with a double stun fear onto Korlek.
As Noble struggling to find pressure in this matchup. A little bit of damage now onto Trill. Still has a touch of Karma, like I said, though. Kidney shot now into Seedu. Finally, Noble getting that raw pressure out. We know RPS has, but Gorecki's still in so much trouble. Not a single defensive cooldown left as he leaps away, trying anything he can to stay alive. The healing wave comes out, fakes out some of the interrupts. DR Asphyxiate comes in, and ultimately, Method Orange with the healer race will win that and claim game number one.
They're still playing it out. They kick Seedu on the heel. Evasion activated. Vendetta, kidney shot. No trinket. Could be potential cross kill. Trill trying to support. Jamili moves in. Lands the fear. Seedu could ultimately fall cross kill. Roasties, though, with no cooldowns. Mez has Icebound Fortitude, but Trill has no touch of Karma. Portals for the heal. Roasties is going to fall here. I believe the damage is enough. Can Jamili 1v2 is now the question. Trill is dangerously low and dotted up behind the pillar. Mez has cooldowns. He's going to be leading the charge, trying to buy space. He silences, trying to stall out the Icebound Fortitude, but Jamili can't stay in this. He's got dispersion. He's staying alive. Trill rotting down still to the dots, but even if Trill falls, I don't think Jamili can take Mez out. He's going to try. Icebound Fortitude gets activated. Gets feared on. Jamili trying to go for the 1v2. Trill's in Shadow with Death Rage, but he just can't get in line of sight, and he's ultimately going to fall, I believe. Jamili trying his best there in those fights.
For
those
when you don't have those, you have to manually single target heal through all the damage, and it's going to put Seedu very far behind. The rest of this game is going to be difficult for him. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to overcome it as Trill gets swapped to. No touch of Karma. He pre-walls the stun. They drop Spearling Totem. Seedu knows that he can't recover from the area of effect damage, but RubCub still has a slew of cooldowns to survive. This composition is paying dividends for Noble. They're just walking all over Method Orange right now.
The most important thing in this matchup is RubCub just standing 50 million miles away. So
oh no, Gorecki!
Can't get that grip. Stun now onto Gorecki. He has no trinket available, but ultimately will survive. Doesn't even have to use the survival instinct, so that swap from Method Orange really didn't get too much there as Gorecki looks to close out this game. He's going to be charging in. Seedu getting very low on mana as well. Dispelling some of those VTs, but he gets feared up. Jamili now right on top of him, able to get out that pressure. Mez as well as Trill rotting low.
Double.
Big Shadow Crash comes in. Triple Fear coming in, and ultimately a big bite coming in from Bolt.
At the final seconds, allows him a moment of breathing room.
Yeah, manages to get topped off immediately with that Divine Favor coming from Rub Cup as well. Now Trill a little bit low, activates the Touch of Karma. They want to continue this pressure onto Jamili. DR Sheep goes out onto Rub Cup, unfortunately DR'd. Full Cyclone, though, coming in from Sidhu. Nicely done. Mass Dispel, I believe, coming from Jamili will remove that Cyclone. And now Noble has an opportunity to get a lot of pressure here onto Samiam. Trill as well, like we said, no Touch of Karma for quite some time. If they can continue this pressure, Trill's forced the port away. Samiam into the middle of the map right now. Sidhu's going to have to play catch up. Down to around 50% mana. Gorecki going over for the full Maim Stun. Jamili in a good position to land that full Fear. Now Samiam's all alone, but good pressure out onto Jamili. Double Leg Sweep coming in from Trill as both Jamili and Gorecki get rotted down.
I mean, this has to be the end of the game. Double Fist of Fury, no defensive cooldowns remaining as Jamili desperately spams out Mind Control, but Rub Cup is still locked down by Samiam. Sidhu moves in for the game-winning clone, but Jamili Mind Controls Trill away to buy at least a couple more seconds. Powered Shield, but it's not enough as Jamili gets closed out. Noble trying to strike back. Could be a potential cross kill. Spareling Totem, though, available. Sidhu restabilized, and Rub Cup has to be panicking right now. Sidhu just gunning him down with Purge.
Trill!
Who cares about Trill? I'm pressing Purge. Rub Cup, though, might have been able to do it. This could be the light at the end of the tunnel. The mind controls have been so critical for Rub Cup to survive.
Yeah, Mez has been caught in that roof for so long. Trill still getting low. Rub Cup caught into the full stun. Can they take him down and qualify for the summer finals? Full stun on Rub Cup. He tips behind the tower. Purge is coming in. Sidhu looking to interrupt. Mez, Trill,
what?
Sidhu all over the place. Rub Cup with the unbelievable kites, keeping himself alive. What an incredible job. Silence now on Sidhu.
Oh, no,
completely
oh, no.
Barely holding on. How are you alive right now? Ultimately will fall, but still,
wait.
Orange in a lot of trouble.
Gregg needs to press survival instincts. He just needs to press it and kill. Trail so low, he pulls away, he falls. Sidhu's got no mana. Sidhu could easily go down as well. He ducks behind the pillar. Mez trying to carry. Sidhu could easily fall. Gregg all over him. He's still got Sidhu's got nothing. He's literally got nothing. He's got an absolute nothing. Is he going to be able to do it? He's caught in the stun. Mez gets speared away. Jamili moves in. Shadow Ward Death. He's hanging on by a thread. Earthen Shield Totem now available. Plops that down instantly. Jamili trying to heal himself back up. Sidhu starting to stabilize. Can he do it?
Can he stay alive just a little bit longer? Gorecki and Jamili need to close out this game. Sidhu gets interrupted, but the Earthen Shield Totem makes him so tanky with that Earth Shield. Jamili forced into the dispersion. They are trying to stay alive for as long as they can, but I think Noble has ran out of time. Sidhu somehow deflects all of this incoming pressure.
Oh, stun.
Gorecki looking for the play. There's
Fear.
The full stun. Double Fear comes in into a silence on Sidhu. Can they take him down? Mez in a good spot, maybe to win the 1v2 if it does end up happening, but the AMZ looks like it will shut it down.
Yeah, Sidhu should be able to restabilize here. He's going to go back to full HP. He's got Astral Shift. Method Orange are now in a commanding position. Mez can basically just do whatever he wants. He trinkets out of the stun, and I think this is it. Double Cap Totem from Method Orange. The all-in strategy ultimately crushes Rub Cup. It was a valiant fight right down to the bitter end. But despite all of their efforts, I believe Noble will have to continue this battle in the lower bracket. They're just annoying Method Orange, trying to make it out of this alive, but it's not enough. Method Orange do it. They throw everything at Noble. The all is
going to get away with it. Now let's look at the cooldowns. Abswitch caught into a Fear. Jelly Beans rotting down, but Chun-Li not connecting to his target. We see a full Kidney Shot. Chanimal now is the priority target for Peekaboo.
Yeah, Kidney Shot into a full trap. Chanimal still in a lot of trouble. Unending Resolve is up, but he's getting lower. Do they have the damage? That's a Hellstone to keep him alive. Jelly Beans in the meantime and Peekaboo both rotting down. Incapacitate over onto Abswitch. Chun-Li looking to reverse the pressure. Peekaboo still taking a little bit of damage right now. Trying to reconnect to his target, caught into the Fist of Fury stun behind the pillar. Kidney Shot from Peekaboo on Chun-Li to try to keep himself alive.
I mean, Peekaboo is dangerously low. Abswitch actually gets Spearhand Strike. Nice off kick there from Chun-Li, putting Abswitch very far behind, trying to recover. Healing Tide Descendants, a cooldown overlap. Those 3-minute timers are really effective against Affliction Warlock damage. Using them at the same time was an emergency situation. Now he won't have that recovery for quite some time. Spirit Link Totem is basically the last line of defense. Dispelling off those dots, we see a stun on Cubsy. Jelly Beans looking to potentially snipe a trap out of that as they swap to Chun-Li with no trinket, looking for the punish. Another stun to instantly take him out of the game. Cubsy trinketing, but one
earlier on when these
trap,
two teams
now Cubsy can dodge it. Jellybeans can maybe use a root trying to land a trap out of that, but it doesn't seem like he's going for it just yet. Cubsy looking for heals. Paralysis Chanimal moving over for potential Fear, but not able to get in range. Instead staying in the safety of that Earthen Shield Totem. Cubsy trying to sneak into Hex, not able to find that. Windshear denies it. There's the paralysis or the succubus play as Jellybeans caught into a Fist of Fear, falling more and more behind. behind, and the longer Peekaboo takes to go for this smoke bomb play, I feel like the worse it's going to get for them.
That cheap shot on channel is a little damage there. I feel like Chun-Li so far has been doing a really good job defusing that. They know their loose condition. There's the full trap on Cubsy. Double stun coming in from Chun-Li, just trying to slow down Jelly Beans and Peekaboo the best he can. Nice gateway coming in from Chanimals, making it really difficult for Jelly Beans to connect. Finally gets their big burst coming in from Jelly Beans, though. It's Chanimals down around 40% HP, still has the unending resolve, really relying on Chun-Li's peels. And
22 seconds as well.
There's the trap onto Cubsy. Who are they going to go on? Peekaboo actually in the Fist of Fury, still getting low. Focus Shadow is going to be traded out. Absurd's really struggling to top him up. Ascendant's going to be used, finally stabilizing the move, but the move has so many options coming up. Smoke Bomb, 5 seconds. Anyone could be dead from Super Frogs.
Yeah, and Cubsy has a hard decision. Who is he going to put Earth Shield on? I feel like he needs to put it on the Warlock or maybe the Windwalker. Chun-Li has to be careful. Absurge should try to drink, but they've got the Fell Hunter positioned. Jellybeans and Peekaboo are moving in. Who is going to fall? The next trap could close the game. He ports the smoke bomb. Chanimal ports the smoke bomb, but gets rooted on his port by Absurge, allowing Peekaboo to reconnect. Jellybeans is split DPSing to make it even more difficult for Cubsy to know who to put Earth Shield on. They trap up Cubsy. They make the swap to Chun-Li with no Earth Shield. Chanimal in emergency mode. What is he going to do to support Chun-Li? Chun-Li, he's not able to do anything, and Chun-Li hangs on by
pressure.
A thread.
Cubsy looking for healing surge once again, trying to stabilize his team. There's the kidney shot. Chanimals all alone. No defensive cooldown into the cheap shot. Full trap on Cubsy. How are you going to live this one, Chanimals? Double Fist of Fury stun coming in from Chun-Li to keep him alive. Chanimals has to kite. He gets kicked by Peekaboo right on top of him. Can they take him down? Fear spam coming in from Chanimals. Absurge moves into position to close out this game as well. Wind shear on Chanimals. Incapacitate Peekaboo. Everything from the move to keep Chanimals down. There's a cheap shot onto Cubsy. Chanimal still just barely hanging on by a thread.
He used unending resolve, I think, way too late. He had an opportunity to use it. Now he might just die right through it. He's on 2%. His tournament life is on the line. Cubsy's caught into a hex. There's no defensive cooldowns available. Drain Soul just desperately to try and stay afloat. Will Chanimal be able to pull off the miracle? Portaling is his gateway cooldown off. He gates on 10%. Is he actually going to make it out alive from this situation if he manages to do it? But Chun-Li gets swapped too. He pre-walled, but it's not enough. As